It's the news Tyrese wanted. He's going to college. Not just any college, but the state university near the town where his grandparents live. He's always had a dream of going to college, but because he was an average student, he wasn't sure he would be accepted, and money was a factor. But this letter was proof that he was on his way to fulfilling his dream of becoming a veterinarian. Although he doesn't know it, Tyrese and others can thank Justin Smith Morrill for their opportunities. Morrill didn't have the chance to attend college, and he wanted to make sure no other child was denied such an opportunity. After many attempts to move the country toward a better educational system, in 1862, the United States Congress finally passed and President Lincoln signed into law what has become known as the Morrill Act. Morrill's land-grant bill was designed to provide education to advance all, black and white alike. But due to segregation, the opportunity for black people in the southern and border states to attend college was not an option. To correct this discrimination, Justin Morrill developed what became known as the Second Morrill Act. This Second Morrill Act, established in 1890, allowed the southern and border states to establish one black and one white institution and still be in compliance. These land-grant institutions became known as 1890s and carry that distinction to this day. It's been 125 years since the Second Morrill Act passed, and in that time, tens of thousands of students have passed through the doors of the country's 19 1890 land-grant universities. From small colleges to major universities, the 1890s carry the distinction of being among some of the country's elite universities. The 1890s inspire thinkers. The 1890s develop entrepreneurs. The 1890s create professionals. The 1890s are student empowering, real world, innovative, practical, creative, community economic engines. And 125 years later, the 1890s still maintain a close relationship with the USDA, a connection that provides a steady and continuous funding source. This country's 1890 land-grant universities take pride in knowing that they provide relevant and distinctive teaching, discovery, and engagement programs that address the priorities and challenges of the global society for a broad spectrum of students. The 1890s can also address nutrition-related health disparities of underserved and other populations with an emphasis on obesity prevention and other wellness-focused programs. They enhance capacity, marketability, profitability, sustainability, and diversity in agricultural enterprises for small and limited resource operations through research-based solutions. They engage youth, especially those with limited resources, in leadership development and in programs and activities that enhance their understanding and interest in science, technology, engineering, and math when planning their education and careers. Through the cooperative extension model, these colleges and universities can provide programs to develop and expand national and international access to sufficient, safe, and nutritious food, as well as ensure that this knowledge is passed on. The 1890s can engage individuals and communities in environmental stewardship and in the sustainability, management, and enhancement of natural resources. The 1890s recognize the issues and concerns of our underserved communities and make their issues a priority. Yes, we have our place and we are proud to continue to provide solutions and innovations to address global priority issues. We recognize our historical significance as land-grant universities.
We want to make sure that Tyrese and others have the opportunities they deserve to attend college, prepare themselves for the world of work, and make positive contributions to the global community. We are the 1890 land-grant universities. We celebrate the accomplishments of the past 125 years, and we prepare for an exciting future as we continue our mission of providing access and enhancing opportunities.